Hello students, I am Ansuya Sharma. So now students, we are going to complete the remaining part of the chapter 1 of Beehive, that is Fun They Had. So we'll start from the paragraph 5. The inspector smiled after he finished and patted Margie's head. He said to her mother, "It is not little girl's fault, Mr. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared too little quick. Those things happen sometimes. I've slowed it up and average 10 years level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Margie's head again. So my dear students, here what happens, it was not Margie's fault that her result was showing worse and worse. It was the computer's fault that the geography sector was geared little too quick. So she was very disappointed and she was not knowing what was the problem with that, and she started hating the school. So now when Margie was disappointed, she had been hoping that they would take the teacher away together. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history had blanked out completely. So she is saying that if she was thinking that the county inspector would take the teacher away. The teacher is the computers, my dear students, which was having a fault. But what did the county inspector did? He repaired it within a second and maintained the geography sector to the average level of Margie. Tommy looked up and he was looking with a superior eyes, means in a very different way, you can say, because it was not kind of school. Stupid, this is old kind of school that they had 100 years ago. Now students, here Margie and Tommy are talking about the schools which we are having nowadays. As you all know, the story is of future, and Margie and Tommy are not having schools like how you and myself had. They are having all mechanical teachers and virtual classes. So now Margie is very desperately thinking how did old schools were. They were very good, as you all know, the fun that you have. But here Margie was only surrounded with computers and mechanical teachers. She thought this was very boring. As in the picture, you can see how future teachers were. How Margie had to learn only with the help of the computer screen, which would start up at a particular given time. So Margie was performing worse and worse. As you all know, my dear students, that the computer was set to a little too quick average level. So now we'll come to the 7th para. A man is not smart enough. Sure, he is. My father knows as much as teacher. He knows almost as much, I betcha. Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, "I would not want a strange man in my house to teach me." Now students, here Tommy is trying to bet Margie. But she is having that thinking, a strange man will come to teach
at her home. But do you, your teachers come to your home to teach you? No, my dear students, you are coming to school. So same way she was thinking that if teachers were human beings, they would have come to your home. For example, your tuition teachers may come to your home for home tuitions. Now, Tommy screamed and laughed. You don't know much, Margi. The teacher did not live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. And all the kids learned the same things. Sure, if they were the same age. Now, students, your classmates are also of your same age. As you all know, your friends eat together, they learn together. Do they learn a particular subject at different time? All the children were sitting together, learning together and having fun together. But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl. It teaches and that each kid has to be taught differently. Here now, her mother said the teachers are adjusting their mind according to the children's. Yes, student, it was true. Like how teachers concentrate on weak students the most. We are putting our total efforts on each and every student so they can do their better. So same way, students, let's continue now. They haven't even finished when Margie's mother called Margi school. Margi looked up. Not yet, Mama, now said Miss Jones. And it's probably time for Tommy too. Margi said to Tommy, can I read the book some more with you? As Margi and Tommy were discussing about the old school and they were describing each and everyone's what they have, their parents have told them about their old schools was going on. By the time it was time to school and Margie's mother called her. So Margie said, Mama, we even have not finished the half part reading the book. Mother said, no Margie, you have to move. So now when the discussion was going on about the old school, now Tommy was trying to tell her that the teacher would come to school and even the students went to school and learned their chapters. But Margi was having that confusion that she did not want any strange man to come home and taught her the lessons. Then Margi was totally now knowing that the teachers were having different buildings where they were staying and the chapters and lessons also were taught. Margi looked up. Not yet, Mama. Now Margi's mother was calling her for school, but she was trying to tell her that they have not even finished the half part of the book. Margi said to Tommy, can I read the book some more with you after school? Maybe, she said nonchalantly. We walked away whistling the dusty old book tucked beneath my arm. So here they are slowly moving with, because they had much interest in the book and they were not having interest in their school. Margi went into the classroom. It was right next to her bedroom and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday. Now, Margi's school was at home, as you all know, students. It was next to her bedroom and the mechanical teacher was waiting for her. As the time was set for Margi and Tommy, each and every day, same time, except on Saturday and Sunday. And you people, in 7 days of week,
You all go 6 days school and only on Sunday you all are having off.
Because her mother said little girls learn better if they learn at regular hours. Yes, student, it's very true. If you regularly learn your lessons, you learn them very nicely. The screen was lit up and it said, "Today, arithmetic lesson. It is on the addition of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot." So students, now what happens when homework is given to you? The homeworks are usually given in your copies, but here in the chapter, Margi had to insert a slot to show her homework. Yes, my dear students, you all are right. So same way, they had to insert one slot in which the correction was made and the result was shown instantly. Margi did so with a sing. She was thinking about the old schools that they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. As you know, students, that this story is 100 and 100 years in future. So all the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing. Whole neighborhood children who went to the same school came laughing, playing together in the schoolyard, sitting together in classroom, going home together at the end of the day and learn the same things. So they could help one another with the homework and talked about it. My dear student, all these things are also done by you. Yes, you are going with home with your friends, eating lunch together with your friends, and even if you have difficulties in doing any homework, you people are talking on phones and even using WhatsApp. I have seen many of my students. Okay, and the teachers were people like us. People means human beings. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen, and when we add fractions 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 4, Margi was thinking about how kids must have loved it in the old schools. She was thinking about the fun they had. And that's all, my students. I hope you enjoyed the story and even the explanation. Thank you.